Hi, my name is Jackson, and today we'll be talking about attrition at Budweiser. Attrition is a costly problem for our company every year, even though we're no longer paying for these employees' salaries. The company suffers because those that are left over from their teams or coworkers have to do their work now. Morale goes down, productivity goes down. Also, we have to find a replacement for them. And so we're paying recruiters to source, to phone screen, to interview. And keep in mind, we're not going to find the perfect candidate right off the bat, and so the costs are just going to pile on. And so today our goal is to really understand what leads to people leaving our company, and we're going to do that using data. We have over 1,000 employee observations from the past year, and whether or not they're still at the company. On your right, you'll see just some characteristics that describe them, how old they are, how much they're traveling for business, how much they're being paid. And we're going to use this data to hopefully identify what leads people to leave. First trend we'll look at today is job roles. Sales rep, 40% of them left our company, and lab technicians, about a quarter of them. On your right is just something that you asked me for last week, which was, you know, who are our happiest workers in the company, and does it have any role with attrition? Research scientists led the charge, health reps following. And from our left graph, we saw that sales reps left the company the most, but they're moderately in the middle in terms of satisfaction, so there's no real correlation there. Those that worked overtime ended up leaving the company more than those that didn't work overtime. Sort of makes sense because they're overworked, they don't want to work anymore. I found this slide to be really funny. Single people left the company the most, and I guess work can't tie them down either. This was something to be done to just sort of address the problem of multicollinearity. So if we're doing a model and, you know, say, for example, job level is a good predictor of why people leave, that may also mean that monthly income can be a good predictor of why people are leaving. So on to modeling. We did 4 logistic regression models with our third model performing best at 88%. There's 18 predictors that have variables in which describe employees leaving our company. And 18 is a lot. If I were to ask you to launch 18 different initiatives right now, that's going to be a lot of money. It may not be a narrow focus in terms of what we're trying to accomplish, which is reducing attrition. And so looking at 4 of these models, they're all around 85% in terms of accuracy level. What were the most common between them? Here were the most common predictors across our models. Business travel. So those who traveled the most, they ended up being the ones that left the company the most. And so maybe it's reducing the burden of travel somehow, or just reducing the amount of travel that they have to do on an annual basis. Distance from home. Those who drove the most to come to work, ended up leaving the company the most, and that kind of makes sense. The commute life isn't the best for everyone, so maybe it's employing a work from home policy. Environment sat and job sat are both very subjective to me, and so maybe that's conducting some employee surveys and understanding what satisfaction means, and how can we kind of better satisfaction for our employees. Marital status, we can't really change people from being single to not being single in a blink of an eye. So maybe it's just engaging our single population more. Maybe it's getting them more involved. Years since last promotion. So some people who didn't understand when their next promotion would be, maybe it's creating a more transparent job ladder so that they're more engaged with the works that they have to do and the milestones in which they have to reach to feel satisfied. That's my recommendation. Let's focus on these 6 predictors and launch initiatives accordingly. Thank you.